Every day, think as you wake up. Today I am fortunate to be alive. I have a precious human life. I am not going to waste it. The goal is not to be better than the other man, but your previous self. Carefully consider what prevents you from living the way you want to live your life. As you breathe in, cherish yourself. As you breathe out, cherish all beings. Love and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. Without them, humanity cannot survive. Our prime purpose in this life is to help others. And if you can't help them, at least don't hurt them. The whole purpose of religion is to facilitate love and compassion, patience, tolerance, humility, and forgiveness. Only the development of compassion and understanding for others can bring us the tranquility and happiness we all seek. Compassion naturally creates a positive atmosphere, and as a result, you feel peaceful and content. Love and compassion are the true religions to me. But to develop this, we do not need to believe in any religion. The topic of compassion is not at all religious business. It is important to know it is human business. It is a question of human survival. Sometimes one creates a dynamic impression by saying something, and sometimes one creates as significant an impression by remaining silent. Where ignorance is our master, there is no possibility of real peace. The way to change others' minds is with affection and not anger. Remember that sometimes not getting what you want is a wonderful stroke of luck. It is very rare or almost impossible that an event can be negative from all points of view. A disciplined mind leads to happiness, and an undisciplined mind leads to suffering. Give the ones you love wings to fly, roots to come back, and reasons to stay. The more you are motivated by love, the more fearless and free your action will be. We can live without religion and meditation, but we cannot survive without human affection. Happiness is not something ready-made. It comes from your own actions. If you want others to be happy, practice compassion. If you want to be happy, practice compassion. Happiness is determined more by one's state of mind than by external events. People take different roads seeking fulfillment and happiness. Just because they're not on your road doesn't mean they've gotten lost. When we feel love and kindness toward others, it not only makes others feel loved and cared for, but it helps us also to develop inner happiness and peace. We need to learn how to want what we have, not to have what we want, in order to get steady and stable happiness. Compassion and happiness are not a sign of weakness, but a sign of strength.